Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video I will show you how to install MX Linux on VirtualBox. In this tutorial you are required to have VirtualBox installed. First open your favorite browser. Then go to google.com. In Google search box type MX Linux. On the Google search results page click on the MX Linux link. Now click the download link menu. MX Linux offers a choice of three installer versions, an XFCE desktop version, a KDE desktop version and a Fluxbox desktop version. Because I want to use the flagship version of the desktop, I downloaded the XFCE version. The MX Linux download process is in progress and may take some time depending on the internet connection speed. Okay, the MX Linux download process is complete. Now click the Show in Finder icon. Then I drag MX Linux ISO to the desktop. Now open VirtualBox. To create a virtual machine click the New button. Then name this virtual machine, since I have MX Linux installed in it, I will go ahead and type MX Linux. In machine folder, type and version just leave it as default. Then click the continue button. And now we get to choose our memory size. So is the physical RAM memory that's going to be allocated by our virtual machine. I'd go ahead and give 8 GB or half of the physical RAM. Then click the continue button. Now we need to add a virtual hard disk to the new machine. So I select create virtual hard disk now then click create button. Next we can choose the type of hard disk file. I'll choose the default and then hit the continue button. Here we can choose the type of disk we want to create. Dynamically allocated storage disk or fixed size storage disk. The dynamically allocated one is usually the best choice. Just because it will save some room on your system. Because the virtual machine will not take up unnecessary space on your system unless it is required by the virtual machine. So it can grow by itself until a certain limit. So I'm going to use that. Then click the continue button. Here I choose a minimum storage space of 40 GB for MX Linux. Then click the create button. Before we start up the machine, let's go into settings and just change a couple things here. First, in the general menu, click the advanced tab. Here you can see two drop downs named shared clipboard and drag and drop. Select each drop down menu and choose the bidirectional option to enable the machine's clipboard sharing and drag drop features. Now click on the system tab. In the boot order, uncheck floppy. Now go to processor tab and I will allocate my two CPU cores to virtual machine. Now go to display tab and on video memory set the size to maximum. Now go to the storage tab. Under controller IDE click empty. Click the disk CD icon then click choose a disk file. Then look for the downloaded MX installer. Select MX Linux installer then click the open button. Now go to ports tab. Click on the USB tab and select USB 3.0 XHCI controller. Then go to the shared folders tab. Click the plus icon to add a new shared folder. Select the folder path drop down and choose other. Here I select the desktop folder to share, then click open. Also select auto mount. Then click OK button. Click the OK button again. Now start virtual machine and you just hit the start button. As you can see, we need to grant access to VirtualBox. So click on Open System Preferences. To unlock, click on the padlock icon in the lower left corner. Enter your Mac admin password, then click on Unlock button. Click Check on VirtualBox, then click the Quit and Reopen button. Now close the Security and Privacy window. Again, we need to grant access to VirtualBox to control this computer using accessibility features. Click the Open System Preferences button again. To unlock, click on the padlock icon in the lower left corner. Enter your Mac admin password, then click on Unlock button. Click Check on VirtualBox. Now close the Security and Privacy window. Now hit Enter to start the MX Linux installation in VirtualBox. We need to grant access to VirtualBox to access microphone, so click OK button. Now to start the installation of MX Linux, click Install MX Linux. First thing in our installer has keyboard settings. Because my keyboard is English keyboard, so I just click Next button. Because it's a new virtual machine with empty storage space, so I choose regular install using entire disk. Then click the Next button. In the warning window, OK to format and use the entire disk for MX Linux, click the Yes button. So it's going to take a while here and start formatting a few things, and the installation has started. The installation process is paused because it requires input from us. Now click Next button. Now we need to enter computer name, computer domain, and also workgroup name. You can also leave it by default. Then click the Next button. Now we can choose our locale, and USA English is fine for me. We also need to configure the clock. Configure the clock according to your region. Then click the Next button. Now create user and password according to your configuration. And don't forget to create a root account password. Check the auto login option if you don't want to enter your password every time you log in to the desktop. Then click the Next button. Now the MX Linux installation process is resumed. Now the MX Linux installation process is complete. Then click Finish button to restart the system. Now press Enter to continue reboot. So we have successfully installed MX Linux in VirtualBox. Now I will try to change to full screen mode. To change to full screen mode, click the View menu and then click Full Screen Mode. Or it could be by pressing the Command plus F key. As you can see, full screen mode works normally without needing to install VirtualBox guest editions. So that's it. If this video is useful, don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, just comment down below. See you in the next video.